For particular method, again we consider an example, a system of equation that is 3x minus y is equals to 2, 2x minus y is equals to 3. It's okay. So now we are going to consider this first equation. Our first step is rewrite the equation as it is, and then bring this equation is a first, this equation is a second. It's okay. Now choose the value of x or y in such a way that we got a coordinate, not in a fraction. It's okay. Therefore, I am going to consider put y is equals to, put y is equals to 1. What's happened? That is 3x minus 1 is equals to 2. What's happened now? 3x is equals to minus 1 transfer to that side. It will become a 3. And answer, we have to got x is equals to 1. 3 upon 3, 1. That's okay. Now what are the order pair we have to got here? A x comma y is equals to 1 comma minus 1. So good. Now put y is equals to, y is equals to, if I am going to take here y is equals to 2, at that time what's happened? Y is equals to 2. Why should I not use y is equals to 2? Just explaining what's happened, what are the difficulties occurs during solving that equation. That is 3x minus 2 is equals to 2. Then I have 3x to transfer at that side, it becomes 2 plus 2, which is equals to 4, 3x, x value. That 3 is going to be divided to the 4. Now that fraction we are unable to plot properly on a graph paper, and that is why I suggest that whatever the value you have to assume, you have to consider, it should be use the value of the variable in such a way that it is not in a fraction. So okay, now we are going to consider another value, that is for y is equals to 4. So okay, what's happened? 3x minus 4 is equals to 2. When I got minus 4 transfer to the right hand side at that time, it got a 2 plus 4, that is 6, that is 3x is equals to 6. And whenever that the 3 is going to be divided to 6, its answer is x is equals to 2. Therefore, the second one where we have to what here, that is x comma y is equals to 2 comma 4. It's okay. In my previous video, I have to suggest that at least 3 solutions are available here, but we will know about that from 2 distinct points, a single line is going to pass. Therefore, it is sufficient to carry out 2 or 3 solution sets. I am going to consider for that example 2 solution sets. Now for this, put y is equals to 1. I am considering a similar value, what's happened? That is 2x minus 1 is equals to 3. 1 is going to be transferred to that side, what's happened? That is 2x is equals to 2x is equals to 4, and with q's, that is 2 to the 4, therefore x is equals to 4. Therefore p x comma y is equals to 4, not 4, it is 2 comma 1. That's okay. Now put y is equals to 3. It's okay. Then what's happened? 2x minus 3. 2x minus 3 is equals to 3. That is 2x is equals to 6. 6 divided by 2. Therefore, x is equals to 3. X is equals to 3. What are the solutions here? Q x comma 1 is equals to 3 comma 3. That's okay. Now we have to prepare the two pairs on the solution set for each equation. Now, what are the next steps? In next step, we are going to prepare the table. In this table, we have to mention what are the values we have to calculate by assuming x, y, a, b. So sorry, we have to prepare only two values. Therefore, x is 1, minus 1, then 2, 4. Similarly for these two, x, y, p, q, whatever the 2, 1, 3, 3. It's okay. So whenever we have to complete this, after completing that, we are going to draw a graph by using a Cartesian coordinate system. We are going to try to solve that system of equation. It's okay. Now I have lack of some sources. I'm going to utilize it properly. That is 1, 1, 2, 3, 4. It's okay. Then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. There's 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Similar math, this side also. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. It's okay. Whenever we have to plot this Cartesian coordinate system and have time, be conscious about the unit distance. Unit distance means the equal distance in between any two consecutive points. It is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. The distance is equal. It is 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. That's okay. Therefore, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, and minus 5. Here also minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, minus 5. Here nothing but x axis. Here is the y axis. That's okay. Now we have to mention first point. That is, this x coordinate is 1 and y coordinate is minus 1. Whenever the y coordinate is minus, at that time that point located in a fourth quadrant. Therefore, there is not much more efforts to you, because you have a graph paper and you have a proper, you make it more properly. It's okay. Now what is the second point? 2, 4. It's okay. Now 2, 4 both are positive, therefore that point located in a first quadrant, that is B, 2, 4. It's okay. Now whenever we have complete it, just draw the line passing through these two points. Okay. Some teachers suggest that you must be recreate the three solution sets. Okay, I also suggest at least whenever in exam you have to must be calculate the at least three solution sets, but due to lack of sources, I am going to consider only two solution sets. So okay, now we are going to plot the coordinate of the second equation, that is first point P, 2, 1. 2, 1 means in a first quadrant here. This is the point P, 2, 1. And what are the second? 3, 3. 3, 3. So, okay. Q, 3, 3. Now I am going to draw a graph, a straight line passing through these two points. So okay, now these two lines are going to be intersect at point, here point is A, which is a solution set, that is 1, minus 1. Means this S, 1, minus 1 is the common solution for a given system of linear equation. It's okay. Now you have to practice yourself on at your home. So thank you for watching the videos.